Gospel today comes from St. John. After Jesus had spoken these words to his disciples, he looked up to heaven and said, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people, to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth, that by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence, with the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. And now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one." The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, your prayer is that we might be one as you and the Father are one. And we confess to you that some things in this world drive us apart and we experience separation from one another. And we pray today for your Holy Spirit, for the unity that you give, that we may live in the love that you have for us. And through that love, see others through you. And grant that we may grow in your love and bring about the oneness and the unity that you desire for our world. Amen. In this priestly prayer of Jesus that we have just heard from John's Gospel, Jesus prays that his followers might know God. And Jesus indicates that that really is what he has been all about in his ministry on this earth, that people might know God. Because knowing God leads us to love others as Jesus loves, and that love brings the unity that God desires for our world. St. Augustine put it this way, "If you love the brother whom you see, you will see God at the same time, because you will see charity itself. And God dwells in it." A week ago, while Naomi and I were in California visiting our son, Peter, who lives in Oakland, California, we were in the Fruitvale neighborhood of Oakland, a mainly Latino, but also Black and Asian neighborhood near where Peter lives. We were standing on the corner of International Boulevard and 39th Street, and a group from the neighborhood walked by, some who were dressed in kind of peculiar ways. And as they passed by, one of them from the group turned his head and looked back at me. "You want to look a little longer? What do you think you're going to see?" It was a mocking kind of question directed at my thoughtless stare. And at that moment, I had to ask myself, what was I looking at? What was I staring at? What was I expecting to see? if you love the brother whom you see, you will see God at the same time, because you will see charity itself, and God dwells in it. Jesus' prayer is that we might know God, and one cannot know God or love God without loving one's neighbor. We are challenged today. We are challenged, really, I think, by that question, how is it that I am showing love? Maybe especially to that person who is most different from me. We live in a time of much cultural, ethnic, economic diversity, and there's a lot of room for letting what is distinctive about us become divisive. It's easy to allow differences to divide. It seems that it's often the order of the day, the way things are in our time. Jesus' prayer, though, draws us into the unity that God intends for the entire human family. Some of you will recall the film Remember the Titans, which is based on a true story. In 1971, the city of Alexandria, Virginia, was split into hostile black and white camps like so many cities in our country following the murder of Martin Luther King. Two schools, a white school and a black high school, were closed in Alexandria, and the two segregated schools and the student bodies joined together in one school, T.C. Williams High School. Many people were upset when the school board appointed Herman Boone to be the head football coach. He was black. And those who were angered expected that Boone would fail and be replaced. However, Coach Boone took command of the boys, and their preseason training included a football camp where he paired white and black players as roommates against their will. He took the team through grueling marathon workouts, including night runs near a Civil War battlefield. The players' disdain for the coach and one another continued. On one night run, he had the players stop and gather around him right beside the historic battlefield, and he spoke to them. "This is where 50,000 men died, right here in this field, fighting the same fight that we are still fighting among ourselves today. The green field right here, painted red, bubbling with the blood of young boys, smoke and hot lead pouring right through their bodies. Listen to their souls, men. I killed my brother with malice in my heart. Hatred destroyed my family. You listen and take a lesson from the dead. If we don't come together right now on this hallowed ground, we too will be destroyed, just like they were. I don't care if you like each other or not, but you will respect each other. And maybe, I don't know, maybe we'll learn to play this game like men." The team was slow to come around, imprisoned by learned racism, festering resentments passed on through their families. They accused each other, distrusted each other. But slowly, as they practiced long hours together, they returned home and began to win games. A bond of brotherhood developed, first among the team and then spreading through the high school and from there to the students' families and from there to the whole city. The narrator ends the film with these words, "People say it can't work, black and white. Well, here we make it work every day. We have disagreements, of course, but before we reach for hate, always, always we remember the Titans." We have a practice of remembering in our Christian community, too. Each time we gather together, we gather around the table of the Lord. We remember our Lord, our crucified and risen Lord Jesus Christ. And we remember our Lord's outstretched arms on the cross, self-giving love, full of compassion and forgiving mercy for us and for all people. We remember that this is the way Jesus demonstrated God's glory. I experienced this from the people in Oakland, California, in the sharing of the peace at church where Naomi and I worshiped last Sunday, in being greeted with Christ's peace by this diverse group of people gathered together to share in the unity of Christ. Black, Latino, Asian, white, Jesus prays, Holy Father, protect them in your name so that they may be one. The body of worshipers was a powerful message in itself as the source of unity. That source is Jesus Christ himself. We come together around Christ out of many diverse identities, and we have those reminders at that time that unity does not come from skin color, that unity does not come from speaking the same primary language, that unity does not come from a uniformity of church doctrine, that unity does not come from thinking all the same regarding religious dogma. Unity, as Jesus lived it out, was always lived out through sacrificial love, self-giving, that was full of compassion and forgiving mercy. In the words of St. Augustine, if you love the brother or the sister whom you see, you will see God at the same time, because you will see charity itself, and God dwells within it. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, help us to see as you see, with self-giving love, full of compassion and mercy. And help us to know God. Lead us to love others, that your love lived out in us might bring about the unity you desire in our world. Amen.